so today I'm going to talk about stress-free dressing or how to always have something to wear. I'm not going to talk about buying new pieces or having expensive pieces, going to fancy brands, none of that. Whether you love shopping from the streets or whether it's utilizing one piece in different ways, I'm going to talk about all of that because that is what I personally do. So today I want to discuss some key pointers that I work around with and that helps me to plan out my outfit for the next day. So the first thing to remember is have a virtual closet. By virtual closet, I mean if you come across an outfit picture, just save that picture. You may find something in your wardrobe that you want to style it in that way. Note down good outfit ideas. So whether it's online, if you're very tech savvy, you can do it on Evernote, you can do it on a Word file. Whether you like making Excels and you have Excel sheets of it, it's all up to you. If I have pen and paper handy, I also tend to note down things, like write down things. So whatever is your comfort level, whether you want to have a small thin notebook of all your outfit ideas that you can refer to, or if you want to file it according to certain outfits, like a plaid shirt, and 5 ways you can style a plaid shirt, or a black skirt and 5 ways you can style a black skirt, or a red lipstick, 5 outfits that you can wear with a red lipstick. Click pictures and file them for future. If you really like an outfit that you're wearing for the day, stand in front of the mirror and click the entire outfit of what you're wearing, from your face makeup to your shoes to your accessories, everything. Just click a street picture of what you're wearing and save it on the computer, and for future you can refer to those and style them again the same way. Not every styling idea can come from within. If you can't find any styling ideas, go on Pinterest, go on Google Images. You'll find so many options and something or the other will ring with you. Build your outfit around themes. So by themes, I mean different occasions. What I do is I have a folder on my system called Wardrobe, and I have different folders in it. So I had 3 folders. One which is street, college or work. 2 which is college and going out somewhere. If you have some plans that you're going out somewhere after college, or if you're going somewhere from work, so you know, according to that. So work and outing, or college and outing. And 3rd was only outing. 3rd folder, which is outing, had 2 subfolders, which is day and night, or casual and party. Now these folder can also have clothes according to seasons. Now it may seem like a tedious job, but trust me guys, once you start building it up, it doesn't take too long, and it's much easier to refer to when you're absolutely out of ideas. Build your outfit around basics. When you go out shopping, make sure you have the basics required in your wardrobe. Whether it's a white shirt, white t-shirt, black t-shirt, a pair of jeans, a pair of black trousers or jeans. If you love colors, go all out, definitely. But when you have basic colors, it's much easier to work an outfit around it. Sometimes we just are so bored of wearing the same piece with another same piece all the time. Break that monotony. If you're wearing a certain top with a certain skirt all the time, or if you tend to wear your clothes with a lot of jeans, switch up to a skirt. On the other hand, if you're more into Indian wear, have some white kurtas, whether it's quarter sleeve, sleeveless, same with black kurtas and different kind of cuts. If you need some inspiration with different kind of kurta cuts and styling, I had a video which I done for on different kurta cuts, which I'll link down below. When it comes to Indian wear, a lot of people tell me that, you know, a kurta is a kurta. You can't really focus on the lower half because the churidar is mostly hidden. Or a sari is an entire piece in its own. So the focus will always be on the sari. Well, I don't think that's true. You can always wear a plain kurta and churidar, or kurta and patiala with a heavy dupatta. You can wear quirky stole with it. You can wear a lot of different kind of jewelry. For saris, you can wear simple saris, whether it's a simple cotton sari or it's a simple chiffon sari with a heavy blouse. So whether it's a fulgari blouse or it's a mirrorwork blouse, there are so many different cuts and colors to experiment with. Build your outfit around statement pieces. Now, when at times I really don't know what to wear, or sometimes I have a new piece that I got, or some piece that I really want to wear, I build my outfit around it. So whether it's a blue pair of pumps that you have, or a big statement neck piece, or these kind of earrings. So don't think of what to wear in a broader perspective. Sometimes I work my outfits around a piece of jewelry. Sometimes I work my outfit around a piece of shoes because I'm really excited to wear a new pair of shoes. So I'll think what clothes will go with those shoes. So it's easier to narrow it down. And it doesn't always have to be shoes or jewelry. It can be makeup. So recently I got these new lip colors. One was a really beautiful red and one was a nude. And I was really looking forward to wearing that red to work. And because that red was for work, I toned it down with a white shirt and black jeans, and that's it. When you're really confused, I think sticking to one piece and building your outfit around it is the best way to go. Enhance one part. If everything is too toned down, you may not feel excited about your outfit. You need to have one statement piece which will make you happy for the experiment. Sometimes we're stuck in a rut because our sense of fashion is something that we are very comfortable with. But try to move away from it. I'm not saying force yourself to. If you like an outfit and if you think, oh, I can't pull it off, try it out. I'm not saying try it out at a big event, but try it out with your closest friends. So experiment, because you never know what you'll start liking. So that's it for the video, guys. If you have any queries regarding this video, or if you have any requests for me, do let me know in the comment section below. And I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.